Hey, it's Angry Weave, and we're back today, guys. We got an exciting one today. Today, we're going to be discussing why Hakiri Kendi is so powerful within Jujutsu Kaisen manga. Hakiri's ability stems from Japanese romance manga. He basically gambles on what's going to happen in the manga. It is a little bit gaggish, just a little bit, but his ability is gambling, essentially. You know, I've been watching a lot of YouTube scalers and a lot of Twitter scalers, and they're saying that he's using luck. His ability is not luck, it's probability. You know, I was searching on YouTube the other day for some good scalers to explain Kenji's power, you know, who could explain it well, and I wasn't impressed. Many scalers don't even realize, as complicated as Hakiri's power seems, many characters within Marvel, DC, other verses have used probability in combat. Domino is a great example from the Marvel Universe, is a example of this. She can use probability to make herself near invincible. Maybe not immortal like Hakiri, but highly versatile ability that allows them to combat threats higher than them. Hakiri is no different, except Hakiri is more physically gifted than Domino. His physical capabilities are beyond the average superhuman. When we are discussing how powerful the Jujutsu Kaisen sorcerer, we must consider two things: the amount of cursed energy they possess, and how do they use or don't use that cursed energy. But I want to make something clear. It seems a lot of YouTube scalers are, and some new scalers are, believing probability is luck. One of the best videos I saw was from Plot Bomber, and he kind of explained, you know, Hakiri Kenji's ability a little bit, but he still didn't explain Hakiri's ability as well as he could have. And I thought maybe only a true power scale would be able to do that. But he did explain the aspect of luck and blessings within Jujutsu Kaisen, which is important, as there are some blessed characters and some non-blessed characters. But probability is not luck. It's a type of mathematical discipline, and that is what Hakiri is using to fight. Shit, when I was in school, I had such a hard time at that section of math, but I do have an understanding of it. So understand that characters such as Domino and Hakiri Kenji are using probability, not luck. And most of the skilled, greatest warriors and characters within verses have the greatest amount of luck. So let's run Hakiri down the pillar system. When we dive into Hakiri's physical strength, his physical strength is unique in that it is connected to his hex ability, Ideal Gamble, which we'll get into. But due to his hex ability, Hakiri's physical strength rises steadily as he gets closer to the jackpot. Due to him having enormous cursed energy, he is capable of reinforcing his physical strength with his cursed energy, thus putting him over well over superhuman strength. He was able to easily send Hajime Kishimoto flying, who was at least well beyond a grade 1 sorcerer, placing Hakiri Kenji's strength somewhere between the tier 2 S and tier 2 B category on the physical strength pillar scale. He would easily be able to destroy multiple buildings and building blocks with his fist alone. Watch as he knocks this dude Hajime through three tankers, metal tankers, drops down on one tanker, squashes that thing, boom, and is capable of incapacitating above average superhuman threats using these techniques that he's displaying right now. As powerful as Hakiri Kenji is physically, his physical strength is not even his greatest skill or pillar. When we drop down to Kiri's speed, I would place him at tier 2B, maybe tier 2C. The reason being, he was not faster than Hajime, as Hajime is one of the fastest Jujutsu Kaisen characters I've seen in the show so far. Granted, he is much faster than the average superhuman, especially when he hits the jackpot. Because Akiri's speed is not attached to his domain, Ideal Gamble, he will have trouble dodging faster than light attacks. I still think faster than light attacks would hit him, and I even think that some high-speed sound attacks would also hit him as well. He is very capable as fast as far as combat, but his speed is nothing to his durability and his physical strength. Hakuri's Ideal Gamble doesn't really enhance his speed as much as I've seen it enhance his durability and his physical strength. And when we drop down to Hakuri's durability, like his physical strength, it is tied to his Hack's ability, Ideal Gamble. Akiri's durability is in the second tier at base level. But when he activates Ideal Gamble, his durability increases drastically according to how close to a jackpot he is. His durability rises to tier 2A when he is at a jackpot level. I believe Akiri at his peak will require all of his sales to be vaporized when he acquires jackpot, placing him with a durability that most superhumans don't even possess. And so when you look and you notice Akiri fight, you're going to notice when he hits the jackpot, he is immortal for 4 minutes and 11 seconds. After using the jackpot, you're no longer able to poison this guy. He instantly regenerates, and his energy is infinite, placing his durability on par, probably surpassing Wolverine and close to super perfect cell level, possibly higher when he's using jackpot. I believe that to destroy Hakuri, you would have to destroy every cell. It would have to be something similar to Gojo's. It would have to be something similar to Gojo's erasure technique, the Purple Hollow. And this ultimately brings us to why Hakuri Kenji is so powerful and why he is the most powerful Jujutsu Kaisen sorcerer in the manga active right now. Because as you know, Gojo is currently sealed. And let me be clear, Scalers, not all of domains classify as Hack's abilities. And it's easy to understand why. But for Hakuri's, his domain is a true Hack's ability. It is the true Hack's domain. Because his domain ignores durability and forcefully sends information to your brain, it can be used on anyone. Granted, he doesn't have a short hit domain, but if Akiri hits the jackpot continuously, he can continuously use his domain repeatedly. And if he keeps hitting the jackpot, it will render his curse energy unlimited for 4 minutes and 11 seconds. And he'll have increased strength and durability and essentially be immortal, stopping at a cellular level. I believe his immortality stops at a cellular level. But essentially, he would be immortal. Hakuri's Hax Pillar or Hax Domain Ideal Gamble is highly powerful because it can be used on anyone. Characters who has an S in the pillar dominate that pillar category. For example, because Hakuri has an S and he's in the second pillar of the superhumans, he is of the top superhuman characters with the highest Hax ability in that pillar. Now don't worry, I haven't forgotten Hakuri's energy projection, which is relatively low as far as we can see so far, but that doesn't mean it is non-existent. Because remember, he can use his curse energy to coat his body and make himself even more durable like Zoraki Kenpachi. He's also able to increase his strength by coating his curse energy around his body. Even though he possesses extremely large quantities of curse energy, his energy projection will fall into the tier 2C pillar. You know, one of the things you have to take away from Hakuri Kenji is that if this guy is able to constantly hit the jackpot and constantly become immortal, have unlimited curse energy, increase his strength, instant regeneration to the point where you have to destroy him, his every cell. You have to destroy every cell in one blast or one move. He is the most powerful Jujutsu Kaisen sorcerer. It is his domain expansion. It's not the probability and luck plays a part in it, but it's the fact that if this dude hits the jackpot, he will continuously become immortal. Every jackpot he hits, and no other character in Jujutsu Kaisen can do this. and this is what makes him so powerful. He can continuously lose his domain in a row. He can use his domain almost 4 or 5 times in a row, essentially becoming immortal for almost 30 minutes if he wanted to. Now again, this is all becomes probability. The probability is that he wouldn't go 5 times in a row, maybe. But you know, it is a math equation where he can get 5 times in a row. You know, all in all, there's a few things to take away from Hakiri. Number one, he isn't using luck. He's using math probability. Math to be exact. He's using math to see how many times he can hit the jackpot and activate his domain continuously, and how many times he can become immortal. The key to beating Hakiri is you have to take this guy out before he enters into his jackpot. The issue is Hakiri at base level is still a very powerful fighter and still at a superhuman level. And number two, Hakiri is probably the strongest Jujutsu Kaisen sorcerer active right now. I know Yuta is very powerful, and I'll get into that. They're probably on par, but I lean towards more Hakiri in battle just due to the rough energy projection output that he puts out, his physical strength. He's not using any Jujutsu Kaisen weapon curse weapons. He's just coming there to beat your ass with his hands. So let me know what you guys think. This is AW and I'm out. Please hit that subscribe and like button.